hits a three-run double into the gap in right center field, and the Phillies come from behind, and they win it 4-3.
Here's the 3-1. Swing and a drive. Down the right field line. It is gone! It is gone! He's unbelievable! Walk-off winner! We are not worthy! Unbelievable! How many times will he do it?
And that is hammered! Oh, my! Fly for Mark Trumbo. 2-0 Halos. I've never seen a baseball go that far in this ballpark.
That one was off the sign where it says Raiders for tickets. 1-800-RAIDERS.
Moss says a single, a homer, and a walk.
Oh, deep to right. This may do it. It is gone. Bottom of the night.
Getting set for baseball from the Windy City. It'll be the Indians and the White Sox coming your way next. Afternoon baseball set to come your way on a fine afternoon on the south side of Chicago. Today it's the finale of this four-game set between the Indians and the Chicago White Sox. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian here with you for this AL Central Division matchup. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Eric, as we get set to finish off this four-game set here today, let's check out what's happened so far.
Yeah, it's been a fairly even series so far. Home sides wound up taking two of the first three. You figure this one could go either way.
We'll hear plenty more from the guys moving forward, but before we do, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Cleveland Indians, as their order will read like this. They'll match up against the veteran southpaw whose numbers you see on your screen, John Danks. Behind him, the White Sox defensively will line up like this. Into the box now stands the leadoff man, Michael Bourne, and we are ready for baseball.
Center fielder, Michael Bourne.
In there, strike one. Bourne in year two now of his four-year deal. Year one found him finishing at 263, six homers and 50 driven in.
And also 23 steals, which was down from his high of 61 back in 2011. I don't think that's a huge deal, but I do think the Indians would like to see him get on base a little more often.
Throw to first, and they'll get the speedy Bourne for the first out of the ballgame.
Good hustle getting down that line. Even on a routine ground ball, you can't take your time. You know, pat your glove, autograph it. Not with this guy running. You've got to get rid of that ball pretty quickly, and they just do get him at first.
Mike Aviles will stand in, and it was his home run that, remember, was the only run they could muster in yesterday's ball game. And here's the first pitch. And a fastball is in there for strike one. Game time temperature just a tick under 50 this afternoon, 49 degrees here at first pitch. Now here's a swing and another chance out there at short. Taken there by Ramirez. Throw gets him, two down. Michael Brantley will get his first opportunity now, and you can see that average pushing up near 350 to start things out. First pitch on the way. And that misses inside, 1-0. He got the high fastball there, and he popped it straight up, way up there on the infield. Davidson is there, and the side is retired. So a fine half inning of work turned in by John Danks. Indians nothing, White Sox coming to bat. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Now the starting lineup for the White Sox looks like this. And there's a look at the starter this lineup will match up against as you take a look at his line on the right side of your screen. Defensively, the Indians will line up this way. Alexi Ramirez will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
For the White Sox, the shortstop, Alexi Ramirez.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Curveball grounded toward second. And taken in out there for the first out.
Batting second, center fielder, Adam Eaton.
Adam Eaton will get his first chance at it now. Didn't factor much into the win yesterday as he took an 0-for-4 in the ballgame. Starting with a high strike here on the fastball on the outside corner. It's 0-1.
Well, this pitching staff has done a pretty darn good job against him in this series.
That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. He swings here and sends one in the air deep down the right field line. Oh, and it's off the foul ball in right for a home run. A solo shot down the line in right as the White Sox are on the board first. It's 1-0.
This is the chance you take when you work up in the zone like this. I mean, this is right in his happy zone, and he jumps all over it and sends it right over the wall.
Alejandro Deaza will stand in for the first time now, looking to keep that hot streak going as he's been hitting the ball well these past six ball games. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
Yeah, he started to go up the ladder there, but then he realized in time that he wasn't going to get there.
Inside corner, a ball and a strike.
Well, there's the location you want right there. If that ball gets hit, it's going to be on the ground.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Now the fastball here is swung on and grounded foul. Here comes a 2-2. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down.
Yeah, a good sequence there against a dangerous hitter. They want to get out of this series with a split, they'll need to keep pitching them the same way they did right here.
Adam Dunn will stand in, hoping to get things turned around here in April as he enters play with an average down in the 220s. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And a fastball here as he rides it the other way into left, a base hit.
Boy, not only was that pitch bearing in tight on him, but it got there in a hurry. You can see he's barely able to get the bat through the zone, but somehow he manages to steer it into left field for a base hit.
Connor Gillespie will stand in, and you see the average there, up over 300 to start the new season. First pitch coming. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike, nothing in one.
And, EK, I don't know about you, but I really hated getting a bad call on that very first pitch.
Hey, jeez, it puts you just in a terrible frame of mind.
Now a broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. And the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. So the White Sox hit the board first on the solo home run. Second inning coming up, and Chicago's off to the early 1-0 lead. Carlos Santana leads things off now in the top half of the second.
First baseman, Carlos Santana.
And this is line foul over the White Sox dugout. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Batting fifth, right fielder, Brandon.
Brandon Moss will get his first opportunity now. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2.
He's found a pretty nice rhythm out here early on.
Here comes the pitch to Moss. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. And a swing as he pulls this one into right. But he'll barely have to move out there in right as he hauls this one in for the second out.
The minute he hits that, he's thinking it's a base hit all the way. But it's one of those situations where you get penalized for hitting the ball too hard. And this stayed up long enough to find the outfielder's glove out there.
Jason Kipnis will stand in here looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. And Danks will get ahead with the fastball for strike one.
And with two outs here and nobody on, if he gets a fastball like that one, he won't be afraid about airing one out here. This is a swing for the fences type situation.
Next pitch, chopped foul right at home plate, and he's behind nothing and two now. A swing and a line drive into right center. That'll be over the head of Beckham, down for a base hit. And he continues to hit the ball well, as that'll push his hitting streak up to seven games now.
Nick Swisher
will get a shot here with two away and a runner at first now following the base hit.
That two-out single seemed harmless enough, but anytime you extend the inning to allow this guy to get a shot with a runner on, better be careful.
And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Now you've got the tying run over at first, two away. He's going to be looking to try and find a gap right here and bring that guy all the way around to score.
And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Boy, and that's about as bad as you can fool a guy. It's 1-2.
Oh, this is exactly where you want that changeup to be. That thing fell right through the bottom of the zone. No chance.
And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. One left for the Tribe. They're down 1-0. Diane Viciedo will stand in. He is off to a dreadful start at the plate, as he has not hit the ball well in April. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now.
Two times here they've gone away, both pretty easy takes. And as a hitter, now I'm thinking it might be time they try to bust something inside.
2-0 on the way. Pitch here fouled away. And he hits the corner with that one. 2-2.
Boy, he just turned that thing over perfectly. He put that thing right on a dime.
Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground, but this is going to be a foul ball, as that keeps things at 2-2. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches. He's laid off a few pitches like that one. And now he's worked his way back to a 3-2 count.
Full count pitch on its way. And a little battle brewing here as he fights off the two strike pitch and chops it foul. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out towards straightaway right. Moss is there, one away. So with one away, let's give you a look at the standings in the American League's Central Division, as you see where these two teams find themselves entering our ballgame here today. Gordon Beckham will stand in. He's got that average pushing up near 300 to start the new season. Now a swing and an easy ground ball to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now. Matt Davidson will dig in now, and as you can see, he's well over 300 here to start this new campaign. And a ball, 1-0. Another fastball. This one he gets by him. It's 1-1.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2.
Nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Yan Gomes will stand in now as he was reinserted back into the lineup here after taking a needed day off yesterday. And the first pitch here is pulled on the ground to third. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
And as we showed you in the open, he's out there putting his perfect record on the line. And so far, these guys haven't shown many signs that they're ready to put a one in that loss column.
Jose Ramirez will come forward now, back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. Comes back with a good changeup there, and it's quickly 0-2.
And it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world here to mix in a take every now and again.
Now a pitch skied out to center field for Adam Eaton. And that's out number two.
Center field number 24, Michael Bourne.
So it's back to the top of the order now. And that'll bring in the speedy center fielder, Michael Bourne. First offering on the way. Cut fastball in there for a called strike.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And with his speed, forget it. It's an infield single.
Much easier to do in retrospect, but you almost wonder if he would have been better served to let this ball go and see if it would have gone foul. There's no guarantees it would have, but that was always going to be a tough play anyway.
Mike Aviles will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. No move from Bourne, now the pitch. And this is yanked hard down the left field line. And that's a fair ball as it'll head for the 330 sign near the bullpen.
Everything changes when you get to the top of this lineup. The number 8 and 9 guys go down without much of a fight. On the mound, he's thinking, hey, I got an easy inning here. But now you get back-to-back hits from the number 1 and 2 guys, you find yourself in a real mess with the heart of the lineup coming up.
Michael Brantley will stand in with 2 on and 2 out here in the third. Ball one.
Showing some confidence in his young catcher to throw that pitch down there with that runner on third base.
Runners on first and third, two away. The 1-0. Fouled back. And this is on the ground toward the hole. And this is a base hit, and that'll get him on the board as this ball game is tied at 1.
And here's something that they haven't been able to do too much in this series. That's come through with the 2-out knock. But for their sake, they've got to hope that's a sign that things might be turning around.
Carlos Santana will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
Let's kill the inning right here.
First pitch coming. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So it's a run on 3 hits, no errors, and 2 men left on. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number 3, all tied at 1-1. Josh Fegley makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number 3. Fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
And he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. The 2-1. And this will be fouled away. And this is in the air now for the center fielder, Bourne. One down.
Well, they took him up the ladder right there with the fastball, and he actually did a pretty good job to get wood on it at all. But it's still an easy play out there in center field.
Alexi Ramirez will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Up with it is Aviles. Throw in time at first for out number 2.
He's been able to bounce back strongly after that first inning home run, and he's set down 6 in a row now since then.
Adam Eaton. We'll see if he can do it again. He homered his first time around. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one.
And even with 2 outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup, so you can't let your guard down.
Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1. Two out, nobody on. And he'll watch the fastball miss down low. It's 2-1. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
The 3-1 pitch. 3-1 pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now.
Well, with this guy, a walk is definitely as good as a hit, so that's probably why he's taking 3-1.
Swing and a ball hit to the left side, and this is going to wind up a souvenir. Swing and a liner. And a close play at the bag, but a good stretch by the first baseman got the out, and the inning is over. Down in order go the White Sox. We played three full. We're tied at one. Brandon Moss will step in to lead it off for Cleveland. He'll be followed in the order by Jason Kipnis. Out in front of the fastball, but this is skied into straightaway right. Vesaido is under it to put it away, and it's a quick one pitch out to begin the fourth. So with the fly out there coming on the fastball, seems like an appropriate time to check out our pitch speed comparison for these two starters. And you can see a 5-mile-an-hour difference on their best fastball there, 97 on one hand to 92 on the other. Jason Kipnis will stand in. A base hit his first time around. First pitch to him. And a high strike there, 0-1. Seems like he's gotten away with more than a few location mistakes so far.
Yeah, and that's not going to last forever, especially in this place.
And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. One run, four hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. Now a ball lined to the right side. And Kipnis is going to reach on a base hit.
There's a guy that's locked in at the plate. Even down 0-2, there's no panic in his approach. When you have that positive mindset at the plate, good things are going to happen.
Nick Swisher will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. And a swing and a ball hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. Now a swing and a ball pulled down the line to third. Throw to first is in time to take care of Swisher, and there are two away now.
Now batting, catcher, Yan Gomes.
Yan Gomes will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
Go back to Cleveland.
And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch. And they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And Beckham will tuck this one away, and the inning is over. Indians lead one. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Alejandro Deaza will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
Left fielder, Alejandro Deaza.
And he drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
Line hard to the left side, but foul. And now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to fairly deep right field. And he can't come up with it cleanly here in right. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
Well, it's never an easy task to have to start an inning by going through three, four, five guys. And obviously, no exception here because he drills this ball and he's going to wind up in second with a leadoff double.
Adam Dunn will dig in. He singled his first time around. Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
Shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
One run on three hits. And no errors so far for the White Sox. Big swing by Dunn, but he's behind in the count now, 0-2.
Boy, he was so far behind that first pitch that he over-adjusted and was so far ahead of this one.
And there's a big swing by Dunn, and he comes up empty, and that's the first out of the inning.
Boy, he just dominated that at-bat right there. You want to see a power pitcher go right through a guy? This is a three-pitch see-you-later right here. Have a seat.
Connor Gillespie will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. No lead to speak of at second. Here's the pitch. Good change up there as he takes command, 0-2.
Two good pitches so far, both of them right at the knees. And you got to start thinking center of the diamond here. Shorten up a little bit. You've got to put something in play.
A swing and a ball hit back up the box. Diane Viciedo will try it again. He flew out his first time. Swung on and bounced up the center of the diamond. Kipnis on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. A man left for the White Sox. Fifth inning coming up, tied at one. Jose Ramirez will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Jose Ramirez.
Here's the first offering. Now this pitch is swung on and lined over the head of the shortstop Ramirez. It's a base hit. Oh, and this goes right past him.
Maybe these guys are going to start getting a little more aggressive here early in the count. Michael, this is the first pitch of the inning, and he's on base here to kick things off.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in the speedy center fielder, Michael Bourne.
He swings at anything. Throw it anywhere.
And a changeup here as this ball's grounded foul. Up and in here as he had to bend out of danger. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
Here's the 1-1 home to Bourne. Opposite field to left. And Bourne is aboard here. It's a base hit.
There you go. Back-to-back singles here to open up the inning, have them set up in a good position to break this deadlock.
Mike Aviles will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
And now we'll try to bunt for a base hit here as he gets this one down. Throw on to first, so the sacrifice is successful.
I don't think you could ask for a whole lot more right here. You get back-to-back singles, then a good sacrifice, and just like that, they're set up for what could be a big inning.
Michael Brantley will stride in, popped out and singled in his two trips. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
Kind of interesting to see how he's going to respond to this situation that he's worked himself into.
Yeah, he hasn't found himself in too many tough spots, but he's got one now.
Some action now in the White Sox bullpen. They'll stand up a lefty and a right-hander to throw. Swing and a ground ball towards the hole. Throw to first, not in time as the run is across to score. Carlos Santana will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Got him to go up the ladder there for strike one.
Boy, he's got to get with the program here. That's an important run down there at third. He can't be chasing pitches like that.
Pitch out, nothing doing. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Big pitch here, 1-2. Now a ball lifted high in the air towards shallow right center field. Vesaido has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And never much of a chance to even think about scoring there. What a big second out.
That just didn't get enough of that one to get that run home. So that's probably a wise decision to hold a third.
Brandon Moss, see what he can do here with two on and two out here in inning number five. Here comes the pitch to Moss. Fastball in there for a called strike. Now a little dribbler here off to the right side of the mound. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Indians forced to settle for one. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the Indians 2 and the White Sox 1. Gordon Beckham will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they've pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Here's Kipnis now, the second baseman. And he's retired here, one away.
That's a nice backhanded play there at second. You'd like to be able to get in front of this ball if you can, but here he does a nice job of looking it into the glove, and then he makes the throw to first for the out.
Matt Davidson will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Swing and a liner towards second, but there to take this one is the second baseman, and that's out number two.
Well, don't worry. I'll tell you, if you keep hitting the ball like this, sooner or later it's going to even out as the season goes on. Just a little unlucky right there as he hits that ball right at him.
Josh Fegley will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
You know, maybe the most impressive thing about his performance so far, he's doing it all in a hitter's ballpark. Now, it's hard to come in here and pitch like this, but he's done a heck of a job.
Here's the 1-0. And he watches a called strike as this one bears in on him. 1-1. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes.
Now you can't look for a specific pitch. You just got to protect the plate.
Here's the 1-2. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. They're down 2-1. Jason Kipnis will stand in to get things going for the Indians in their half of the sixth.
Jason Kipnis.
Some action now in the White Sox bullpen. They'll stand up a lefty and a right-hander to throw. Now here's the ball hit sharply toward the right side. And that'll get down for a base hit. So he goes after the first pitch, and it's early trouble here this half of the inning. So with the leadoff man aboard, we take a trip into the recent past here as we call on our graphic for today's edition of This Date in Baseball History. Nick Swisher will dig in for the third time now. He's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips.
Let's go!
Here's the first offering.
Whip!
Swing and he pops him up over near second. And the catch will be made here by Ramirez, one gone.
And if this ball's hit maybe just a little bit harder, he might have a shot at doubling a man off. But since it's hit so softly, he's only going to wind up getting one out.
Yan Gomes will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances.
Come on, White Sox!
Big swing there as it's hit pretty well out toward deep left field. And there's out number two as this is taken in shy of the track and the runner will have to retreat.
Whoa, and as a pitcher, you hold your breath anytime a ball's hit in the air at this place. But luckily, he got under this ball a little bit too much and that runner has to retreat back to first base.
Jose Ramirez will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. Fastball hit on the ground is short. They'll go the short way to Beckham, and that ends the inning. Just a four-pitch inning there as the Indians go down quietly as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Alexi Ramirez will be the batter as we get things going in the bottom of the sixth.
A shortstop, Alexi Ramirez.
And who? Looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's nothing and one. For that man right there, just the one run allowed. The question is, can he make that lead stand up?
Well, he hasn't shown too many signs of cracking so far. He's got the look of someone right now who's ready to go the distance.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. And he goes the other way with a fastball as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. Under it is Bourne to make the play for the first out.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was the solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
Adam Eaton will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on. Now here's the first pitch. And this is low, ball one. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. Out in front of the fastball here as he lifts a fly ball out toward right field. Moss is there, two down.
Oh, no.
And here in these middle innings, they just haven't been able to get anything going against him out there. And that's seven in a row now. He's set down here in the fourth, fifth, and sixth.
Alejandro Deaza will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Get out of here.
Open stance by Deaza. Here's the pitch. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And Aviles will make the catch and the side is retired. The speedy Michael Bourne will start things out when we come back. It's the Indians 2 and the White Sox 1. Back here on the south side of Chicago. Seventh inning coming up with the Indians on top. But before we get any further, let's check out our game summary for the first six innings. Michael Bourne will stand in here to start the seventh. EK, it's been a pitching and defense afternoon all throughout.
Yeah, neither starter looking like he's ready to blink. And neither one of them looking all that tired just yet.
First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0.
Even though he's given up his share of hits so far, he still hasn't walked anybody, so at least he's got that going for him.
And here's his fastball for a called strike one, and he's hitting an even 90 on the gun. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. But he's going to haul this one in on the run as he winds up just shy of the wall for the first down.
And really, from what we've seen here so far this afternoon, balls just don't seem to have a whole lot of carry to them. And this was another example right there.
Mike Aviles will stand in. Sacrifice bunt his last time. Now a swing and a miss as they start him out on a pitch well inside for strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
On the ground to third. On to first, and there were two down. Michael Brantley will get another crack, one for three thus far. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole, and that'll get down for a two-out single.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see, and he was right on that one.
Carlos Santana will stand in, trying to change his evil ways here. He is hitless in the ballgame so far. Fastball swung on and hit on the ground at third. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. One left for the Tribe. They lead it 2-1. Adam Dunn will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6, as they try to get something going.
This whole lineup's been pretty quiet all game long. Just the one run, that's it.
You'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one.
Well, you know, things have gone his way more often than not so far this afternoon, but he certainly didn't get any help on that one.
Now the 1-0 pitch. First two pitches off the mark here. It's 2-0.
And down by a run, a leadoff walk would certainly help the cause. He's got to shrink that strike zone here and not chase anything that he shouldn't be swinging at.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Yeah, you know, he probably got the fastball he was looking for, but on 2-0, you can look for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side. And the throw on to first will take care of him, so he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away.
You just get the sense that he's got it on cruise control out there now. Make it 9 in a row, he's set now.
Connor Gillespie will stand in. He grounded into a fielder's choice his last time. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. Got him out on his front foot there as it swung on and missed for strike one. You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. Off-speed pitch, and there is strike three called. And boy, that zone just got a bit larger, two away.
And you know, he really doesn't have to throw that changeup all that much for it to be an effective pitch. You can see what his breakdown is so far.
Diane Viciedo will dig in. He's flown out and hit into a double play in two trips. Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
Ball hit high to the right side, but this will get into the seats foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Fouled straight back. Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. It'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
Here we go.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Down in order go the White Sox. They still trail it here 2-1. Donnie Veal is into the ballgame now as he'll make his fifth appearance of the season here. Brandon Moss get us going now in the top half of the eighth.
Right fielder, Brandon Moss.
Breaking ball that's cut on and missed for the first strike. Comes back with a good changeup there, and it's quickly 0-2.
He's playing right into that big swing from a pitch before. Just throw something slow here, and you'll probably have him 3 feet out in front.
Here comes the pitch to Moss. Fouled straight back. I ran that one in on him a bit, as this time it's tapped foul at home plate. On a good curveball, gets him swinging for out number one. Time to bring you up to date on the numbers for our two starters. It's our starter comparison, and the hometown nine have had trouble generating much by way of hits, as you can see by the left side of your screen. Jason Kipnis will try and keep it going. 3-for-3 thus far. And that swung on and missed for strike one. Now a swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. This ball will be chopped foul. And this is a swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt as they'll need to throw down to first. And he will recover in time to get it over to first. Nicely done there as they record the second out.
Kind of a double-edged sword right there. He wants to bounce a curveball to get a swing through, and he gets it, but then he's got to worry about that ball maybe getting away. Fortunately, that's a nice play to keep it close and get the runner out at first.
Nick Swisher will stand in. He popped out in his last time. Now a pitch swung on and hit to the left side, but this is going to find the seats, a foul ball. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Swing and a shot toward right center, and that's going to be a base hit for Swisher.
He's gotten off to a really slow start here in April. Well, maybe this can help him snap out of it. That's a sharp single there.
Yan Gomes will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Line hard, but this will be a foul ball. Now a ball hit hard but foul as this one forces the third base coach to dance out of danger. And this is fouled back and out of play. And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. Two out with the man at first. Changeup had him fooled a bit as this is on the ground to third. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Indians lead one. They still lead it 2-1. Paul Konerko will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 14, Paul Konerko.
Is strike one call to the 37-year-old veteran up there. Nothing and one. Well, the guy you see right there has been terrific. Well, will they let him work these final two innings?
Well, I think the pitch count is in his favor. Everybody pays a lot of attention to that. So barring a huge spike right here in the eighth, I don't see any reason why he can't get these final six outs.
Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Swing and a ball headed towards the hole. And now against his body, a jump throw. Throw will not be in time, so good hustle there as now the possible tying run is aboard to lead things off here.
Well, we've seen winning rallies get started with less than this. This is going to be an infield single all the way, and now they're in business with the leadoff man on base to start this inning.
Jeff Kepinger will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. Here comes the Indians manager to make that slow trip to the mound. And it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart with the lead and a chance to be the winner, but he is responsible for the tying run at first. Josh Tomlin will get the assignment on the mound here as he'll enter with the runner at first and nobody out.
Josh Tomlin.
In there, no balls and a strike. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Lead by Canerco, now the pitch. Swing and a ball bounced back up the middle. And a diving effort there, but it'll come up empty. It's a base hit.
A good job here. He stays inside the ball well, doesn't roll over, and just shoots his ball right back up the middle.
Josh Fegley will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Some stirring now in the Cleveland bullpen. They'll get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing. Showing bunt here, but he takes ball one.
And you know, I've always thought, if you're pretty sure a guy might be trying to bunt, then put that first pitch out of the strike zone. Make him show you his intentions. Maybe you get him to offer it something that he shouldn't.
Runner holding tight at second, now the pitch. And this one's bunted out in front of the plate. Throw to first, not in time. So now everybody's safe.
Oh, and with two guys on already, they couldn't afford to make this any worse, but they managed to do it here by somehow turning a clear sacrifice attempt into a bunt single. That could really come back to hurt.
Alexi Ramirez will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. But he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
And obviously looking for the ground ball here as this misses low. It's 1-0.
So right here is where you've got to be smart out there. They've got nowhere to put you, so he probably won't be working the corners.
And, ooh, looked like a definite pitcher's pitch there on the inside, 1-1.
Oh, he's got a legitimate gripe right there. I don't know about that one.
Possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Nobody out. Oh, this is hit to third. Will it be two? Kipnis. Throw to first is not in time. And we've got ourselves a tie ball game.
Well, I'm a little surprised that he wouldn't come home with this ball. That's always going to be a tough turn at second for the double play. And you know you're only going to get one, so why not take the lead runner at home to save yourself a run?
Adam Eaton will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one.
Your attention, please.
So a call to the bullpen now, and they'll make a move for the left-hander here. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Some stirring now in the Cleveland bullpen. They'll get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing. Good hard sinker swung on and missed, 0-2. Tough spot here for a left-handed hitter facing a guy that's exceptionally tough on lefties.
Yeah, you generally get so many at-bats against right-handed pitching. Now you're in a good RBI spot, and you're stuck facing a guy like this.
is a swing and a ground ball. Throw on to first for the second out, but meanwhile, that all-important go-ahead run is in to score.
And here's just a case of a guy at the plate doing the little things to help his team win. And he gives his guys the lead here following the RBI groundout.
Alejandro Deaza will step in with a big opportunity to get that insurance run home from second. And he gets some pretty good wood on it here as this is lifted to fairly deep left. And Brantley will make the catch, and that ends the inning. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. We've played eight full. It's the White Sox 3 and the Indians 2. Paul Konerko will stay in the ballgame now as he comes on to play second here.
Now playing second base, number 14, Paul Konerko.
Jeff Kepinger will stay in the ballgame as he'll take over at first base. And on to try and seal the deal here is the hard-throwing right-hander Matt Lindstrom. Jose Ramirez will be the first one to greet him here as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here, nothing in one.
And you've got work to do up there now that you're trailing. You don't want to help him out right here at the start.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. And this is going to be a foul ball. Another 0-2 home. And now here's the ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. And not the start they were hoping for as the leadoff man is kept off base to start the ninth. John Axford is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Michael Bourne will try again. 2-for-4 in the ballgame. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. And a fastball is hit on the ground towards short. Throw on to first, and now the Indians are down to their final out.
And that's what the two-seam fastball will do for you. Running away, not just for strikeouts. Here he gets them to hit it on the ground for an easy out.
Mike Aviles will stride in, grounded out his last time through. Lonnie Chisenhall will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. First pitch, and he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Now he might have been on the on-deck circle just saying, man, I get one at-bat, it's against this guy? Thanks a lot.
Swing and a miss, and now the Tribe finds themselves down to their last strike.
Can't tie the game swinging at balls.
Now this crowd, right around 35,000 strong, on their feet. Swing and a hot shot toward third. And this is going to be a fair ball as it'll head to the corner.
And you just had the feeling that even though they were down to their final strike, they were not going to go down easily. And now they're going to keep this game alive for at least one more batter.
Michael Brantley will step in with the tying run on first, so he's got to concentrate and work on getting on base here. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw on to first will take care of him, and the White Sox have made it a memorable weekend. They take 3 out of 4 as this ball game is over.
Well, you know, some late game heroics in the bottom of the eighth were what proved to be the difference as they rallied back to win in front of a very enthusiastic home crowd.
Definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Not a lot of offense to go around in this one, but what offense we did see came from this man's bat. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, and I think we probably could have given this award to 3 or 4 different people, but you definitely can't overlook his contribution. He really played a great ball game.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, get those smartphones and tablets out and head over to theshownation.com. The White Sox win it 3-2. So long from Chicago.